Metolius, Oregon. Metolius is a city in Jefferson County, Oregon, United States. The city is named for the Metolius River, a nearby tributary of the Deschutes River. The name for both comes from the Warm Springs or Sahaptin word mitula, meaning white salmon and referring to a light-colored Chinook salmon and not a whitefish. The population was 880 at the 2010 census. According to the United States Census Bureau, the city has a total area of all of it land. This region experiences warm, but not hot, and dry summers, with no average monthly temperatures above. According to the Köppen Climate Classification System, Metolius has a warm summer Mediterranean climate, abbreviated CSB on climate maps. Metolius was founded in the early 1900s. The earliest records are from 1903 and written in German. In February 1911, the Oregon Trunk Railroad decided to build a depot, turntable and roundhouse in the town. The railroad was connected to Bend, Oregon. Railroad engines at the time needed water at regular intervals, and Metolius was picked as a servicing spot. Electricity was provided in 1912 from a small dam at the cove. A high school and grade school were built in 1913. The town continued to prosper during the war years, and by 1917, the population was over 1,700. The town boasted two banks, two newspapers, a flour mill, hotels, general stores, hardware stores, and a railroad maintenance hub. As railroad technology improved, maintenance stations were required less frequently, and the Metolius shop was eliminated. Without the railroad base, the population of Metolius went into decline. A major fire in the 1920s destroyed most of the downtown buildings. Drought from 1924 to 1926 drove many farmers broke. Then the Great Depression almost finished off the town of Metolius. By 1945, the population was down to about 45 people. Prior to the 1940s, only dry farming existed in the area. An irrigation project diverting water from the Deschutes River boosted farming output, and the town began to grow again. Through an extensive canal system, water from the Deschutes River reaches the area. Farmers were now able to grow large crops, mostly mint, potatoes and hay. By 1960, over 3,000 railroad cars of fresh potatoes were loaded each year from the area. Four giant packing sheds stored fresh packed potatoes and delivered them onto railroad cars. A frozen French fry factory employed many workers year-round. In 1968, a potato blight of nematodes ended large-scale potato production in this area. In 1973, the railroad closed its depot in Metolius. By 1990, almost all mint production had ended due to root rot. Now in 2007, most agricultural production around Metolius is marginal. In 1950, Metolius Elementary began to grow out of the 1913 high school building with a new gym and two classrooms. Four more classrooms are built in 1955 to teach the children in the town, which was growing due to the influx of agricultural workers and workers here to build three dams which now block the Deschutes River. About 1963, the old high school is destroyed, students now go to Madras, and the elementary was again expanded to include an office, a library and two more classrooms. Its last expansion occurred in 2000 with the addition of six new classrooms and a large modern library. The first Spanish-speaking people families begin to settle in Metolius in the 1950s, drawn by field work, hoeing, irrigating and harvesting, as well as working in potato sheds. Non-union mills converting scrap wood from lumber operations hired many more Spanish-speaking workers from Mexico. Now over 50% of the students at Metolius Elementary speak Spanish at home. Around 1970, a fire in the city's post office led to the end of the zip code for the community, and it afterward shared the zip code of nearby Madras. However, in late 2003, city leaders enlisted the help of U.S. Representative Greg Walden to reclaim the code. "We're just trying to get the town to have its own personality again," said Metolius Mayor Daryl Agee. "Right now, it's solely a bedroom community for Madras. The zip code is just one step toward the future." Despite several attempts to start businesses, Metolius serves mainly as a bedroom community to Madras and other larger towns up to away. A prison is being built in Madras, and new homes are being built for its workers. As of the census of 2010, there were 710 people, 275 households, and 190 families residing in the city. The population density was: there were 297 housing units at an average density of. The racial makeup of the city was 75.6% white, 1.0% African American, 3.8% Native American, 0.6% Asian, 0.1% Pacific Islander, 14.8% from other races, and 4.1% from two or more races. Hispanic or Latino of any race were 23.7% of the population. There were 275 households, of which 37.8% had children under the age of 18 living with them, 49.5% were married couples living together, 13.8% had a female householder with no husband present, 5.8% had a male householder with no wife present, and 30.9% were non-families. 23.6% of all households were made up of individuals and 8% had someone living alone who was 65 years of age or older. The average household size was 2.58 and the average family size was 3.03. The median age in the city was 38.6 years. 26.2% of residents were under the age of 18, 7.3% were between the ages of 18 and 24, 25.7% were from 25 to 44. 31% were from 45 to 64, and 9.7% were 65 years of age or older. The gender makeup of the city was 50.0% male and 50.0% female. As of the census of 2000, there were 635 people, 214 households, and 161 families residing in the city. The population density was 1,549.7 people per square mile, 598.0 per square kilometer. There were 220 housing units at an average density of 536.9 per square mile, 207.2 per square kilometer. The racial makeup of the city was 77.17% white, 0.16% African American, 2.05% Native American, 0.63% Asian, 13.23% from other races, and 6.77% from two or more races. Hispanic or Latino of any race were 22.68% of the population. There were 214 households, out of which 40.7% had children under the age of 18 living with them, 57.0% were married couples living together, 13.1% had a female householder with no husband present, and 24.3% were non-families. 21.0% of all households were made up of individuals and 7.9% had someone living alone who was 65 years of age or older. The average household size was 2.97 and the average family size was 3.41. In the city, the population was spread out with 35.3% under the age of 18, 6.6% from 18 to 24, 31.5% from 25 to 44, 15.4% from 45 to 64, and 11.2% who were 65 years of age or older. The median age was 30 years. For every 100 females, there were 106.2 males. For every 100 females age 18 and over, there were 99.5 males. The median income for a household in the city was $32,375, and the median income for a family was $34,028. Males had a median income of $30,893 versus $21,607 for females. The per capita income for the city was $11,963. About 14.0% of families and 16.6% of the population were below the poverty line, including 18.3% of those under age 18 and 15.0% of those age 65 or over. Thanks for watching. Don't forget like the video and don't forget to subscribe.